Greetings, Pograms. RDS here with another video. Having some issues with my computer here for some reason. Trying to get this recording to go. But anywho, back at y'all with another video. Gonna talk about the Division in its current state. At least my impressions anyways. So, 1-30 was pretty fun. Not gonna lie, game was fun. You know, it was cool. Had some form of a storyline, which is whatever. Really wasn't what I was looking forward to as far as like them telling a story. Like it really didn't have any meat to it. It was just kind of like go here, do this, go here, do that, which is whatever, which is fine. You know what I'm saying? It's the mad dash to level cap anyways, to end game, right? Like that's the whole point. Get to end game, do the dark zone, do raids, you know, whatever, big, you know, challenge modes and all that stuff. So you know, so you get to the 1-30, you know, you're messing around with different skills, and you're unlocking your base of operation, and you're going through the game, and, you know, you're shooting a bunch of bad dudes, and you're learning about this virus, and you're learning about, you know, what's happened to Manhattan and all that good stuff, and, you know, so that was fine. It was average, you know, it was fun. It wasn't like anything like, oh my god, greatest game of the year. And it's kind of unfortunate because, like, there's no reason to replay through the game. And like to make another character because like there's no classes, which I think kind of hurts the game. I think that would have made the game easier to shape around with a class-based system. You know, and then you can have like the sets based on the classes, and then you know there can be like different. Could have been like different stuff like. If they would have had like the three different classes, basically like the Holy Trinity, sorry, and basically what you would have had is, you know, you would have had like your tank, which is just your security guy. You could have had like the tank, could have had the riot shield, the smart cover, like those could have been all three of his or four of that abilities, like, and then you can like modify them and add more like, add more of the mod, different mods to each of the skills, and then have like the talents specific to that class. Like, so there's a whole bunch of talents that you can mix and match. And you know, if you want to be more of a damagey kind of tank, or if you want to be more tanky, kind of dude, and then like there can be like different variants of it. So, like, no one tank could be the same kind of deal. You know, especially with like the different weapons and the different, you know, the different mods and stuff you can do to the different techs. I think that would have been fun, you know, and like the whole shield bashing could have been like a mechanic, and holding threat, and you know, taking damage and stuff like that. There could have been like, you know, and you got like healers, you know, and like the healers could have been kind of like, you know, healing slash DOT kind of like a dot kind of class, where like, you know, they can, if enemies are standing in your health pool, it does damage to them or makes them, you know, it might disorient them as they enter the circle or if they exit the circle, like, you know, the radius of the healing. Healing stuff could have damaged or weakened armor or something like that. Could have been like a debuffer, like an enfeebling kind of class. And then like, you know, tech could have just been like balls to the wall damage, like, you know, glass cannons as it were. But unfortunately that's not here, and that kind of sucks. Like, it really sucks that there's no classes, because the game's just kind of like, you know, like, play kind of like they want to be open, right? Like, play whatever you want, do whatever you want. And I just don't think it works out very well in the end, you know, for many reasons. And, you know, one of my many issues, and that's some kind of just some of my ideas how they can make this game more more balanced, I think would be a class system, you know. Maybe you can, and then you can add classes. I don't know if they plan on adding more skills, more talents, whatever, down the roads as level cap goes up. But, you know, you get to the end game, you know, and you're like, you get these three, there's three set gear that you can get. There's four pieces. It's like a, what is it, like knee pads, a holster, a mask, gloves, and like a backpack, and like your armor is like whatever, I guess. I don't even know if they have, I haven't even looked to see if there is a chest piece for any of the sets. But you get those, and there's bonuses, and that's kind of cool. There's bonuses that you can get from it, and that's kind of neat. But then, like, you know, so there's, like, this mad dash, right, to get, like, one of the set pieces, like, to get the set gear. And, like, the loot table is just, like, so all over the place. Like, you get, like, random garbage. You don't get anything appropriate, you know, to help build your character. You know, because there's not very many opportunities to get into something. Like, basically, you do a challenging run, right? And you, and right now, everybody's farming whatever Lexington Event Center or whatever. So you run that, you get 30 Phoenix points. You know, you're guaranteed a gold, which usually the gold is garbage. And you know, there's like a low chance that you can get one of the set pieces. So I've run that at least several times already. I've gotten absolutely no upgrades, and the only upgrade I managed to build was from schematics that I bought with my Phoenix points. So if that's gonna be like how I get gear, that kind of, that really sucks. Like, that's kind of boring. Like, no one wants to grind out gear unless it's like, you know, you're doing different things, or you know, there's opportunity to get like bonus credits and stuff like that, like bonus Phoenix points, you know, which you do the challenges and the daily assignments. And there's that stuff, which is kind of cool. Some of it is in the Dark Zone, which I think is a huge issue, which I'll get into it here in a second. There's not enough end game content, like, for PvE side. There should be way more than there is. Like, I really think that the Dark Zone should have been held off for them to, like, kind of mold it into something better. And I have my ideas on that. And I just think that there should be more PvE. I think the incursion, there should be two incursions right now. There should be, like, you know, low level, like, you know, hey, if you have, like zero to whatever gear score, this is good for you to get some decent shit and to get some credits and stuff, and Phoenix credits. And you can farm this, whatever, every week, whatever it may be. And then there should be a second incursion, which is, like, you know, freaking hard as shit, right? Like, for the higher tier, you know, like, 160 plus. 161, which seems to be their sweet spot, but it doesn't really, because I'm like 180 and I'm doing like challenging mode and I get blasted in one hit, like one hit downs me, and I have a lot of health, like 50k health, which isn't like a lot. I know people that have like 100 something thousand, but you know, for a gear score 180 and to have like decent amount of health, like maybe I need more health, I don't know. But you know, I'm not a glass cannon. I'm trying to be like a tank, you know, with the riot shield, blah blah blah. And, you know, the game kind of, like, they're more, like, the game is catered to, like, a certain play style. You know, like, the cookie-cutter build, which is unfortunate because I hate games like that. You know, I don't want to play the way everybody wants me to play. I want to play the game the way I want to play the game. You know what I mean? I bought the game. It's my character. Let me be viable the way I want to play them, not, you know, the way everybody else plays. You know what I mean? And that's the problem with the whole, like, classless system, like, not having classes. Because there's no, like, there's no balance, there's no structure, it's just do the most damage and not die. Like, that's literally the game. Like, shoot bullet sponges until they die and not die. Try not to die within one hit, which is impossible when you got super sniper shotgun dudes that, like, hit you from, like, a mile away and you go down. Like, it's just dumb. And then the AI, that's, like, completely random, dudes just, like, run up on you. And they don't, you know, if they're going to be, like, a shotgunner, they should have, like, less armor. Like, they should be easier to kill, you know, because it's, like, kind of like that trade-off. Like, hey, I could down you in one hit if I run up on you, but if you see me in time and down me first, like, you know, that's the trade, right? That's a play style, which that's what this game's all about. It's not, like, a class system. It's not like I can take, like, a shit ton of damage. It's not like I can be healed through damage, you know what I mean? Because the game's not built that way, which sucks. So yeah, so you have that, and like I said, it's just not fun, like, endgame stuff, and people are already talking about it's dying, and it's boring, and blah, 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 and that's why, because, like, people expected basically, like, you know, Borderlands, you know what I mean, or, like, you know, I guess in a lesser degree, Destiny, which I didn't like Destiny at all, and I hate the fact that this game mimics Destiny, and the fact that it came out incomplete. It wasn't a finished product. You know, I think the Dark Zone should have been held off. It should have been, they should have waited a year for the Dark Zone. I think PvP should never be a focus. Unless you're doing, like, typical verse stuff, like Capture the Flag, Team Deathmatch, King of the Hill, stuff like that. That would be fun. And then that will segue me into my Dark Zone issues. Dark Zone's stupid. It's just dumb. It just doesn't make any sense. There's no purpose for it at all. Like, none. Other than fucking open PvP, like, period. There should have been, you know, with the class system would have been cool. Because then I would have made, like, strategies more viable. There should be, like, you know, only so many. I think they should break it down in tiers And, like, whatever tier you enter, like, you know, as you, like, you know, from 1 to 10 is DZ1, right? And then, like, from 11 to 20 is DZ2, or 21 is DZ2, like, the sections, right? Like, the areas. There's, like, 5 areas. And that's how they can, like, break people down. Like, if you're in if your Dark Zone score or rank or whatever is, like, 50, you're in DZ5, and you're stuck in DZ5. Like, you cannot leave DZ5 and own fucking newbies. Like, that's dumb, because I still get penalized at the same rate as anybody else. Like, that's not fair. That's not fun. That's not fair. It's not intuitive at all, like, as far as my progression in the game. And I really think they should change that. I think the DZ should have been more verse-based, like, or they could have did both. Like, you can go into the Dark Zone, and you can choose whether to do, like, you know, open, you know, free range, free roam, PvP, do whatever, just run around this area and cheat shit what it is now, or, you know, hey, I want to do Capture the Flag, and, like, play Capture the Flag, or, like, Team Deathmatch, and that's what the DZ should have been. Or, the DZ could have been, like, you know, very challenging dungeons that were new, and you only can reach them, you know, and then, like, you can unlock newer ones as you gain more Dark Zone ranks, and, you know, and you can gain Dark Zone ranks any which way you want, right? Whichever is fun to you. It should be player choice, and not just, hey, you're going to Dark Zone, you're going to get freaking owned by, like, you know, a group of 20 people that are all on voice, you know, group chat, and they're all buddies, and they're all just going to, like, zerg the entire Dark Zone, and you can't get and do anything. You call for a chopper, you're just dead. Drop all your shit. You know, fuck you, pay me. And that's what bothers me the most. And I'm sorry to be so ranty about it, but it's like, how do you fuck this up? Like, seriously, there have been so many games before The Division that have done it right. Look at fucking Borderlands. They've done it right. They did it right. They're doing it right. If they came up with their version of The Division, or, like, Destiny, like Borderlands version, Borderlands would be the best. Like, it would be the best at it, because the co-op would be awesome. It would be fun. It's got classes, and it had raid-type bosses, you know, raid bosses and stuff like that, which this game should have. You know, and they should have done something more with the virus. Should have been more, like, mutated type stuff, like, as you get further. So you can have variant enemy types, you know, and, you know, it's like, oh, they're big boss, big helicopter, here you go, or an APC, that's the boss fight. Like, okay. And I understand the game's, like, supposed to be realistic. It's Tom Clancy, which I think was the issue with the game. It shouldn't have been a Tom Clancy game. It should have been called The Division, and just been its own IP, and make this fantasy kind of, like, you know, fantasy or, like, a sci-fi military game, and it would have been freaking cool, and could have had the different classes and different weapons and, like, you know, where's my grenade launcher? You know what I mean? Like, but enemies have grenade launchers. And it's just, you know, just, and, like, the AI is just stupid. And, like, I like how enemies can, like, drop from, like, 20 feet in the air, hit the ground, nothing happens. They don't lose a speck of health. But you fall from, like, 1 foot above your character's height and you freaking take, like, a whole block of damage. What? So, I don't know. It's just, there's so many inconsistencies. I've fallen through the wall, gotten stuck and stuff, and, like, like I said, with the AI just doing, like, the randomest things in the world. And basically, me ranting just sounds like I hate this game, and I don't. I think this game is fun, and it does have a lot of potential to be great. They just need to fix a lot of stuff, obviously. The game wasn't ready to be launched, and I think the Dark Zone either should have been held off for them to, like, fine-tune it, do a beta thing, you know what I mean, and get people's feedback and really listen to the people. I think they just threw the Dark Zone in because it was just easy, like, hey, this is Endgame. Like, it's easy. We didn't have to do fucking jack shit for it. We just threw in a whole bunch of named enemies with random names and a whole bunch of enemies, and you just run around and you shoot shit until you get cool loot, and then you extract it and then try not to die. Not fun at all. Like, not even in the slightest. It's not even in the slightestly fun at all. Like, it's just fucking stupid. So yeah, those are my thoughts. Those are my ideas. Like I said, the game is fun. It's obviously fun with friends, and it's the way I recommend playing the game. I soloed most of my level, I think, until, like, 26, 27, then I started playing with my buddy, got to level 30, did some Dark Zone stuff with him, I've done the incursion with him, and that's been fun, but playing by yourself, just not at all, like, because there's not much to do, like, you're just doing the same thing over and over and over again, like, literally the same thing, you know, and they've been patching out exploits, and, like, banning people for exploits, and, like, you know, but the Dark Zone is one big exploit, so you might as well just ban everybody that's in the fucking Dark Zone, because you can't go in there alone, or you'll just get killed. You can't do shit in there by yourself, unless, like, your gear score is, like, over 200. Because, like, you know, you get those supply drops, and, like, I tried to solo one, and, like, you know, I'm I'm taking down dudes one at a time, and then like a group of four rolls up on me and they're like, hey, get the fuck out of here. Literally, get the fuck out of here, this is ours. Nothing I can do. I can't take on four guys by myself because there's no class system. There's no way to like be superior via player skill. It's gonna come down to my gun's bigger than yours and you're dead. Within shots. Within like five shots. Like headshots, you're dead. So, you know, that's my thoughts. I hope they fix this game. They're passionate. They're working hard. I know this is like their big game for the year because they're not doing an Assassin's Creed. So they're definitely going to be focusing on this game for a whole year. They have a year plan. But their year plan that they, their roadmap that they had a video for wasn't impressive. Like, I just wasn't impressed at all. I'm just kind of like, I haven't even bought the season pass yet because I'm really just like not, you know, hopeful that they're gonna make the right choices. Like, I know a class system will never happen. It's just my thoughts on that. Like, I know that'll never happen, but they fix the other stuff to make it more like player choice and allow me to do more stuff on my own. I think that'd be fun. So we'll see what happens. That's my thoughts on The Division. That's all I got for y'all on this one. So what do you think? Let's drop some comments. Tell me what you think, what you hate about the game, what you like about the game. If you quit playing, let's talk about it. Thumbs up, thumbs down, do what you gotta do. You know, talk. Let's talk about The Division. I'm on the Xbox One. Kuzlo is the name. C-U-Z-L-O-W. It's in the videos if you wanna watch those too. So let's play some Division. Let's make this game good. Let's make it fun. So, as always, keep it gaming, guys. Peace.